There's a lot of truth in the old saying that hurt people hurt people. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, what I like to do is take a look at what's happening in the YouTube community, take this mess and turn it into a message, because there's always a lot that we can personally learn from these situations. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And before I get started, I just wanna let you know, I am feeling good today, all right? I just made a video earlier this morning about kind of the self-care that I did yesterday for my depression, so check that out. But anyways, I'm feeling even better today because I just had a therapy session, and God, I always say everybody needs therapy. Everybody needs therapy. And anyways, I just had a great therapy session. I might do a video about some things that we talked about, or I might just put up a video on Patreon or something like that. But anyways, like, if you're struggling with your mental health and getting clarity and understanding like just what's going on with you, like, give therapy a try, all right? Like I always say, I don't care how you get therapy or where you get therapy, just give it a chance, all right? So you can talk to your doctor, your insurance company, see if they can recommend a therapist, friends, family members. My therapist, personally, I use BetterHelp Online Therapy, and I also have an affiliate link with them, so if you wanna try it out, it's down in the description below. Basically, what that means is that you get some affordable online therapy. You can message them whenever the heck you want, schedule phone sessions, video sessions, whatever it is. I do phone sessions, and a little bit goes back to support the channel when you sign up. All right, get you some therapy, girl. Okay, anyways, let's talk about this situation. And I just wanted to discuss this because, so I was watching the new Spill video, and Spill, oh, best tea channel out there. Like the research and everything that goes into that. I have a theory about who's behind the Spill channel. I might make a video on that. If you want me to talk about my theory, let me know in the comments below, because I have one. But anyways, yes, they were. She was talking about, you know, the Trisha Paytas Nikocado Avocado situation. So I'm gonna link both the Spill videos down below as well. It's two parts, both of them are about 30 minutes each. But what I wanted to focus on in this video, because a lot of us can relate to this, is Spill brought up the point that it's possible, or very likely even, that Trisha Paytas might have ghosted Nick because of what she had going on personally in her own life. And girl, I can relate to that. All right, so for those of you who haven't watched it yet, basically, during that time, Trisha Paytas was going through some personal stuff with a relationship and everything like that, at the same time that Nikocado Avocado was in LA when she ghosted him, all right? And this is something that a lot of us can relate to. Like, I can tell you from personal experience, when my mental health is not doing well, like I mentioned in the last video I did, like I can get into a pity party. I can feel sorry for myself, I can feel bad for myself, and I just don't want any human interaction at all. And I can understand and I can empathize with Trisha Paytas of why she did that during that time. And it sucks, man. Like, okay, you know what? Screw it, I'll give you a prime example. I was in Florida in March for Playlist Live, and I was there for an awesome event, got to meet some awesome people, but I was going through a lot of personal things during that time. One of my best friends and former roommates, he lives out there in Florida where I was, and I was gonna hang out with him while I was there, but I was just not in the mental space to do anything, and I kind of just zoned out, shut out, and everything like that. But what I'll talk about later in this video is what we do about that, all right? So the first thing is, although we feel that way and we don't wanna talk to anybody, we might ignore calls, we might ignore texts or anything like that, something that I found that is very beneficial for me, and it might help you as well, is to communicate it. Communicate when you are going through something, all right? Something that some of us struggle with is that we expect other people to read our minds, right? We expect other people to just know, to know we're going through something, right? Like, how dare they ask me to do this or that? Why don't they understand that I'm going through something? Well, the reality is, if we don't tell people that we're going through something, how are they supposed to know? So communication is key. Like yesterday when I was dealing with my own mental health issues, like I communicated that with my girlfriend. I communicated that with my son. Like I told him, I said, hey man, like I'm sorry, like I'm not as energetic today and I don't wanna do all these things. Like I'm going through it today. And when you communicate that with people, like, believe it or not, like, a lot of them are understanding and very compassionate. And when you look at the situation with Trisha Paytas and Nikocado Avocado, like, think about what could be avoided, right? If she would have texted him back and said, hey man, I'm really sorry, I know you're in town, but I'm just going through a lot right now, I can't do it. Like, just picture that for a second and imagine how this situation would have turned out if that was communicated, right? So for you personally, like, I understand we all have our days and we all have our ups and downs, especially if you're somebody like myself who struggles with depression, who struggles with anxiety. We don't know when it's gonna come. We do not know when it's going to hit. But something that we should be doing is training ourselves to reach out and let people know that we're not okay. One is so that they understand that if we lash out or if we do something different, like ghost on them or something like that, like, they know it's not them, right? Like, you saw this in Nikocado Avocado's, like, text messages, like, is it me? Is it something that I did? And during that time, it had nothing to do with him. It doesn't seem like it had anything to do with Nick. And that's my opinion on that situation. But when I communicate this, or when you communicate this to other people, they know that it's not about them. Because, girl, we are some very selfish, self-centered people, right? When somebody acts a certain way towards us, we think we did something to them. What did I do? Why are you angry at me? When the reality is that it could be something completely different going on. So that's why it's important that we communicate this to people. Now, there are gonna be times when we are just really deep in it and we're not going to adequately communicate that to people. Like, it happens. There's gonna be days when we don't answer calls, when we don't answer texts, whatever it is, because we're going through it. Like, when I talk about my pity party method, like, I give myself X amount of hours to just sit and just feel bad for myself and feel sorry for myself and all of that, and then I get into action. For other people, like, depending on how, you know, you've been actively working on your mental health, you might need an entire day or whatever it is, just no calls, no texts, no nothing, whatever that might be. But something that I've learned is, out of respect for the other people in our lives, whether it's in our personal lives or in our business lives, is letting them know and apologizing for it, right? Like, getting back to them and saying, like, hey, I'm sorry I didn't get back to you yesterday. Right? I'm sorry I didn't return your text. I'm sorry I didn't return your call. And depending on who that is, who that relationship is with, like, obviously it's gonna be different if it's, like, you know, a coworker or, like, you know, a best friend or a family member. Like, you can gauge how much you're going to tell them. But, like, if it's a friend of mine, I'll say, hey, I'm sorry I didn't get back to you yesterday. Like, yesterday I was having a really rough day. You know what I mean? Like, if it's, like, a coworker or somebody else where you ain't got a relationship like that, you can just apologize for not getting back to them that day. And listen, I am all for honesty and everything like that, but there's a certain amount of information that we might wanna keep close to the chest. So in these situations, like, I don't think it's a huge deal if you say, hey, sorry I didn't get back to you yesterday, I was really busy. Like, you don't have to tell them all of your, you know, mental health issues that you are dealing with if you don't have that type of relationship. But I think it is important to follow up with people and apologize to them if you did not get back to them. Like, this is just a part of training our own personal responsibility, our own personal accountability, and just letting people know. If not, they might believe that we're gonna do this over and over and over again. And then what happens is that their opinion of us really starts to change, and then we get confused as to why. But if we look at our past, it's because we didn't apologize for where we went wrong or what we screwed up. So again, this video is mainly for you. These are things that I've learned, and I hope some of these tips can help you out as well. But I just really want you all to sit back and think about this for a second. Like, in the context of the Nikocado Avocado and Trisha Paytas situation that most of you have been following, just imagine for a second a couple things. Imagine if, when Nick was in LA, if Trisha said, hey, sorry, like, I have some personal stuff going on. Imagine what the outcome would have been. And even if that didn't happen, imagine if days, weeks, heck, even months later, if Trisha would have reached out to Nick and said, hey, sorry I kind of ghosted you while you were in town, I wasn't really doing too hot, you know, whatever it is. And that doesn't even mean that you would have had to reschedule a collab or anything like that. But think about what that would have meant to Nick, had she done that? All right? Like, there's so many things that we're watching on YouTube and we're watching all this drama going on and we're just passively watching it, right? But I want you to take a look at your own life and reflect and say, okay, what can I learn from this? How can I improve my relationships? How can I improve my life? How can I improve my mental and emotional well-being based on the situations that I'm watching? Because all of us deal with this type of stuff, so there's definitely a lot that we can learn from each one of these situations, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell because I make a ton of videos. And make sure you're following me over on Instagram and Twitter at The Rewired Soul. Also, a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And if you would like to help support what I'm doing here, get access to our monthly Q&A and some other perks and benefits, click or tap on that Patreon icon right there. All right? Thanks again so, so much for watching. I'll see you next time.